Welcome to Mr. Belle Kitchen today. First of all, I'd like to thank all my subscribers and all my new viewer watchers and everything. And if you haven't subscribed and you're thinking about subscribing, that's all you have to do is hit that button, ding, and you are subscribed to Mr. Belle Kitchen. Today, I'm still going down that list. Today, someone asked me to make some baked macaroni and cheese in the Power XL. Well, as you know, I told him, I said, I left a comment say I have some mac and cheese in there and I have some different kind of cheese and everything, but they want to see the baked macaroni and cheese. So today I'm going to be doing baked macaroni and cheese, and today my ingredients is I'm going to be using this Tillamook cheese, extra sharp, and I'm going to be using 1 teaspoon of garlic salt, and 1 teaspoon seasoned salt, 1 teaspoon black pepper, 3 eggs, and some medium Tillamook cheese to slice, and some pepper jack cheese too, to give it that little good extra taste to it. And I'll be using 1 box of Penne noodles. As you see, it's a different kind. I'm gonna use it in 2 cups of milk. And what I'm gonna do, I have my pot on, so I'm gonna pour these noodles right in this pot over here. You see my water's boiling, I'm gonna put a little water in there. And what I'll be doing, I'll be pouring these noodles into this pot to make it nice and good. And that's, I'm gonna pour them in a minute and get them nice and cooked. Okay, and I'm gonna shred my cheese right on this grater like this, and just grate it all up nice and good and everything, so it'll be nice and ready. So, you know, the holidays is coming up, so I'm glad someone did ask me to make mac and cheese, because sometimes our ovens get full and we wonder, oh, I got one more dish to cook. We wonder what we're gonna cook it in. By having these extra things like the Power XL and everything, that come in handy. You can just put it in the Power XL and just cook it. It's gonna be delicious. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna pour these noodles in, as you see, pour it in the pot nice and good. What I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna stir it around for a minute. As you see, the butter's nice and good in there, so they won't stick. So I'm just gonna let this boil for a couple minutes and take them out, and we're gonna get started. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add my milk into this bowl, just like that. And I'm just gonna put my little 3 eggs in here, mix it up. And just put them in just like that, break them and put them in there, like that. Put them all in there like that, and I'm gonna pour my black pepper in there, like that. Season salt, and I'ma just throw that garlic salt. I'm just gonna take it and mix it up just like this. If you have a whisk, just mix it up with the whisk. Nice and easy, just mix it up just like that. Mix it up good, just like that. Mix it up until you get nice and good. And everything, as you see, is mixing up good. Okay, my noodles is done. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna pour them right in this zinc right here in the strainer and let it sit for a minute and pour them in just like that. And I'm gonna just let them sit right in there and drain out a little. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna sit it in this pot. Right back in the pot. And let it sit. And I'm sitting in this pot and let it sit for a minute. Let most of all the water drain out of it. So when I get ready to put it in the Power XL, and everything will be fine. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna set my Power XL and cut it on and let it get ready to preheat. So what I'm gonna do, I'm put it on bake. It's on bake. I'm gonna set the timer right there. I'm gonna set it for 375. 375. I'm gonna hit timer. I'm gonna set the minutes for 35 minutes. And I'm gonna press start. And I'm gonna let it preheat. Okay, now it says add food. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna add little noodles in there. And nice, good, and hot. And spread it in there like that. put a little in at a time. And spread it all in there. And put that in just like this. Put it in nice and good. What I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna lay some of this cheese in over it like that. Yeah, make it nice and good. And spread it in like that. Then you pour a little juice over it. Just pour a little, just get it nice and good. Like that. So you get all the way in there. Then what I'm gonna do next, I'm gonna put a little more noodles over that. Just put it in like that. And make this baked macaroni gonna be so good. And I'm just gonna spread some of this cheese over it. Just make it, in other words, it's gonna be real cheesy and good when I get done with it. Just like that. Put it in like that. Put a little more juice over it. And pour it all over so it just, cause everything could just melt right on it. Now, what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna pour the rest of the cheese over it, the macaroni over it, just like this. And put it in there, like that. And now I'm gonna put some of this pepper jack cheese over it, like this. Some of this pepper jack, and just put it in like that. Put the regular cheese on top of it. Then I'm gonna pour the rest of the eggs over it like that, the juice and the milk, and I'm gonna close it. And we're gonna be looking at this together, press start. There you go.
And for my first time viewers watching Mr. Belle Kitchen, the way I like to do it while this is cooking, I'm gonna wash up the dishes. Don't leave it for the spouse, don't leave it for your kids, don't leave it for anyone. Because they're gonna be thinking about they had to wash the dishes. So I'm gonna do this while this cooking, so when we eat it, everybody be happy. You don't have to worry about who's washing dishes. I'm gonna wash them.
Gonna take a little sneak peek at it and see how it's cooking and everything. It's been about 18 minutes. I'm gonna look at it. It's looking good and everything. As you see, that's looking real good. And everything's nice, getting nice, good, and brown, that thing. I'm gonna just stick this in here for a minute and see how it is. Oh yeah, nice and cheesy. Oh yeah. I'm gonna let it cook a little while longer and let that inside cook a little bit more. Good start. That's it. Okay, now I'm gonna raise it up. And everything's looking good. And I'm checking it out, and I'm gonna let it finish cooking for the next few minutes. I'm just gonna cut it so it get all in the inside of it. And I'm gonna close it, and it's already going. Okay, I'm gonna raise it up, and I'm gonna take it out. I'm gonna press cancel that, and take it out. And this right here should be nice and done right now. Sit it right here. It's hot right now to taste, so I'm gonna taste it later. Okay, I'm gonna taste it. I put some in the sauce, it tastes good. And sorry, I forgot to do the first video of the tasting, but it was tasting so good. I kind of resisted a little bit, but I'm gonna taste it again. And it came out good. And you can taste the pepper jack cheese and everything in it. Everything good, that is delicious. But that's cooking with the Belles. That's the baked macaroni and cheese. And if you like it, leave a comment in the box. If you haven't subscribed, that's all you have to do. Ding! And hit that button, and you are subscribed to Mr. Belle Kitchen. Like, I have a lot of videos already on cheese and mac and cheese and different videos. If you like it, just leave a comment in the box. Thank you for watching.